Oh, good afternoon. This is Cynthia 212. I am coming in here for just a quick update of what's been going on with me. Well, first of all, with Devon, I went yesterday to his dayhab program that he goes to. It's time for him to have his psych eval. When you're in a day program for adults with special needs, I think their first 30 days there, it's been well over 30 days. They were supposed to have been did this meeting. You just come together and discuss the progress that he's had and what you want to update on his IEP. It used to be called the IEP, but the IEP is like when you're in school. So when you get out of school, I believe it's called the ISP. Still the same goddamn thing. But so we did that yesterday. It's time for Devon's psych eval. Update for them to do his psych eval. On his last psych eval was when he was in high school last year. The new diagnosis with him was that he was diagnosed with paranoid schizophrenia. And that's not in his IEP now. So then there needs to be an update with his psych eval so they can make sure they put that on his ISP so he can, so everyone involved in the programs with him would be aware of what his mental condition is and be aware of how to better assist him. And that would open up more doors for him to have more programs that could be accessible to him. So that's what we're going to do with him. And they always have such wonderful things to say about Devon. It just makes you feel so good as a parent to hear. I'm telling you, everywhere I go, every program or school setting or everywhere Devon goes, they always give a glowing report about how wonderful he is and how respectful he is and just what a wonderful gentleman he is. So that made me feel real good. Being a single parent, raising children in the projects, you know, it's kind of hard to keep, you know, our kids on the straight and narrow, you know. So for them to say how wonderful he is and what a great person he is and what a great job I did as, you know, in parenting him and guiding him, it's a wonderful thing. Okay. Junior is still with the Skip of New York, but he hasn't had any services yet. A lot of the services that we're trying to get him, he's still on the waiting list for. And I told y'all before with the budget cuts, you could be on the waiting list. Your child can be on the waiting list for at least a year or two. Some programs is like 5 to 10 years waiting list, which is ridiculous. So we're trying to get him into a summer program this summer for like 2 weeks. He'll take like 2 weeks out to go to like a day program to where Devon did this also when he was younger, but he phased out when he was 21, to where he'll go to like a camp or something like that for the day, and they'll do things, a day summer camp. So we're trying to get him into that, and hopefully we can get him into that for the summer, which is good. Junior will still be going to school all year round. He's in an autistic school, so he goes all year round, which is excellent, wonderful. Yes, he will definitely go. It for the summertime, it's not mandatory, but me, I'm thinking like, what can it hurt? You know what I'm saying? He won't be on my damn nerves all summer. So he will be, his schedule is still stay the same. He'll be in school from like 8 to 3, which is good, you know. Sometimes when the kids take off for the summer, they lose, you know, everything that they learned throughout the school year. So I just want him to stay on track. Like I told you before, when he started this autistic school, he started out like a 20, 30 percentile. Now he's been in there since last year, September. We've got his average up to like 80, 90%. So that's pat myself on the back. Hard work and dedication and working with the school to improve his reading and math and, you know, stuff like that. So he's doing well. Allie's doing well too. She, I think her, what is that? Like the SATs, I think is coming up. I think they only got like a couple of more weeks into school. So hopefully she'll do good and pass everything. So she and her ass don't got to go to summer school again. Like she did last year. So she's doing well. She's still in her counseling. She's been in counseling since she was like 12. So she's still going into counseling, and that's going very well. And if she does not have to go to summer school this year, she will be going down south for the summer to visit her grandmother, which is wonderful. And as far as me today, I went to have my first psych appointment with a psychiatrist. As you know, I told y'all before, I think this time last year I was 207 pounds. I am 260 pounds, and I have been emotionally eating these past couple of months. So my weight loss doctor, my nutritionist, and my medical doctor suggest that that I see a psychiatrist to find out why I've gained so much weight, which I know I'm emotionally eating from, you know, everything that's going on. I went back to my old ways of coping with, you know, Devon being diagnosed and back and forth into the psych ward, and Junior being autistic and running with his, you know, things with him. And just, it's really hard at times being a single parent. And then on top of that, having two special needs children and a teenager, it's very, very difficult and overwhelming at times. So they suggested that I go to a psychiatrist, and I met my psychiatrist today for the first time. I had to do like a questionnaire test. She said that I am like overwhelmed and kind of depressed. So she said it was like moderate, like a lower stand of moderate depressed. Just basically, she said that I need to find management skills to do what I want to do for myself, as far as going to school, being more social, being more, you know, taking care of myself, exercising more. So she's going to work with me on that. So I have two psychiatrists that she wanted me to see. So I see her next week, and then in 2 weeks I see another psychiatrist, and he's the one that helps me with managing, coping with managing everything that that I do on a day-to-day basis. She basically was like the intake psychiatrist. I guess evaluate me, to sit down and, you know, see why am I here and what did the doctor say and stuff like that. So she prescribed me some pills that's supposed to release the endorphins in your body to help you not feel so down, so depressed, or just me crying and stuff like that. I told you I'm not really too keen on pills, because like I told y'all, addiction runs in my family. But she said that this was a very low dosage of the medicine that she wants to put me on. She said she wants to do a 7-day trial to see how I feel and cope with the medicine within the next 7 days. And if I feel better, or if it makes me feel better, to start the 20-day. When she gave me two prescriptions, one was for 7 days and the other one was for 20 days until I see her again. I don't know. Was it? I don't know the name of it. I don't know if it's Prozac. I don't know. I have to go pick up my prescription, because what they do now is they put your prescriptions electronically to the pharmacist. So she said some name. So I'll pick that up today. And I'm really scared to take it, y'all. I don't like medicine. I don't like pills. That stuff just scares me, because like I said, addiction runs in my family. She assured me that this wasn't an addiction medicine that she was giving me. Like, you don't get addicted on it. But I don't know. It still scares me, because, you know, my mother was a drug addict. My father was a drug addict. You know, I had other family members that were drug addicts. I just think that can become hereditary. So it kind of scares me in a way. But I don't know. She said you know, she was like, just try it out and see how it goes. But I don't know. It kind of scares me. But anyway, enough with that. So that is it. Everything other than that is going pretty well. The kids are doing well. I'm doing okay. This weekend, I'm going to get my fat ass up and go to the goddamn gym. I'm paying for a damn membership that I ain't been there in a while. So my son said he'll go to the gym with me. I'm trying. Like I said, I'm around it off. I'm 260. So I want to lose 60 pounds, hopefully by December. So, yeah. Yeah, so that's it. Just coming here really quick just to give a quick update. And I will talk to you later. And remember to say good morning, good evening, good night to someone with a smile. It will definitely brighten their day, evening, or night. And God bless you all. Bye.